first thing you want to do to make these cookies is get yourself a lollipop cookie mold just like this. Now, we purchased this at the craft store. While we were there, we also got lollipop sticks. I got myself a medium size and a larger size. You want to spray your mold with some vegetable oil spray, and then I made some dough from my favorite sugar cookie recipe. It's as simple as just giving it a nice press, and you're just going to fill them up all the way up to the top until they're nice and flush. And then you're going to take one of your sticks. You're just gonna insert it right here. Gives you this little groove, and you wanna put it in about halfway. So I'm gonna continue working on all these, and I think Kathy's gonna show you her icing recipe.
I'm gonna get started with some royal icing, and the first thing that you're gonna wanna do is get 3 egg whites. Now these are pasteurized egg whites, and the way I know that is that the eggs come marked with a P. This doesn't get cooked, so you wanna make sure that you use pasteurized ones. I've got 1/2 teaspoon of cream of tartar. We're gonna give this a quick mix until this gets pretty frothy. I think that's looking pretty good. Now I'm gonna slowly add to this 1 pound of sifted confectioner's sugar. We're gonna add a little bit at a time. So light and fluffy, look at that. And just keep mixing. A little bit more. This recipe is gonna make plenty of icing for the cookies. Another mix on that. How are they coming?
They're coming along. Finishing up my last mold here.
Starting to form up. I think we'll add the rest of the sugar, all that in. It's got a real nice firmness to it. I think we are all done.
And I'm done too. I have all my molds filled with my sugar cookie dough here. My sticks are in, and my oven's been preheating at 400 degrees, and I'm gonna put these in for about 8 to 10 minutes.
I'm gonna add some food coloring to this. Let's scoop some of this out.
Here are some finished ones, Kath. Look at that.
Those look fantastic. So I'm gonna add to this some blue food coloring. Just got some of our blue color there, right there on a tongue depressor.
And you certainly don't need too much of that.
No,
food coloring.
Not at all.
Long, long way.
Just a little bit. I think that is just about the ocean blue I am looking for. So I have a piping bag here, and I'm just gonna feed in the bottom of it, the first part of the nozzle, and then fill in with our blue icing. I've got our blue icing all mixed up and in our bag. We're just gonna snip our tip here. Go ahead and place a number 3 tip on top. Screw this right on down. And how about a cookie for icing?
There you go, got one ready for you.
We're gonna do some ocean waves. And then just sort of a nice big smile down at the bottom. And then just go in and fill in your waves. Get that good and filled in.
Yum.
This ocean blue is making me want to dive right on into the Pacific. I've got some dark gray here, and of course, our ocean scene wouldn't be complete without a seagull. A cute little bird. You're gonna want to set this aside and let it dry till all the icing's nice and solid. Once it is, you can just put 1 single cello bag and a ribbon on this if you want to give 1 cookie as a gift to someone who may be traveling. Mm-hmm. It's a great little treat.
And if you have a lot of cookies you want to give, a bucket works really great. All we did is we added some marbles to the bottom for some weight, and right at the top we put a piece of styrofoam to fit, and then we used brown sugar to resemble sand.
So for the traveler in your life,
send them off with a cookie bouquet.